Rahu and Ketu are so unpredictable. They say that even God doesn't know what they will do in their dashas. Alright, so today after watching this video, you will get rid of all the confusions which you have about Rahu and Ketu's results. Because today I will show you with an example chart how to predict the results of Rahu and Ketu. Alright, so Rahu and Ketu are known as unknown planets, which is actually wrong because they are not unknown, they are unpredictable. Alright, so for example, if Rahu is in the 10th house, you might suddenly get a call from somebody if the dasha is active or other yogas are supporting in the horoscope that, my dear sir, my dear madam, there's a promotion, would you like to take it? And you would be like, is it me? Or is it somebody else? Alright, so it doesn't mean that they are unknown. So many times people tell me that there is nobody who can predict Rahu and Ketu's results. All right, so nothing like that. Their rules of prediction are just the same. A bit new rules are added to it. Okay, so there is no fancy out of the world technique for Rahu and Ketu's prediction. The prediction techniques are same, but two or three new rules are added to it. All right, so I will tell you what are those rules, and let me share my screen here. Okay, I hope you can see that. Okay, so this is the example chart of a person who is born in Mumbai, and this person is into stocks. Okay, and this person currently stays in the US, and this person is a very big consultant. This person is literally making millions in consulting. Okay, and I won't give more details, so please do not ask me much more. I have to maintain the level of privacy here. All right, so here Rahu and Ketu. So I have open two charts here. So this is one chart, and this is the main chart. This is the Lagna chart. Okay, so this chart which you see, this is the Lagna chart. This is also known as ascendant chart or Rashi chart. Okay, and this is Navamsha, and this chart which you are seeing here, this is known as the Bhava chart. I will make it a bit big. Okay, we will come to this later, so I will hide this behind. All right, because when we are taking Rahu Ketu's results into consideration, we need to make sure we are looking at the Bhava chart properly. Okay, along with the Lagna chart, both are very important when it comes to Rahu and Ketu. So what is the first rule for Rahu and Ketu? And yes, as usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And this video will be a bit advanced level of astrology. So if you are new to astrology, then please go to my astrology basics playlist, all right? And if you want a consultation from me, then please go down to the description section of my videos to my website. And yes, it's Rahu. So I must say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So what is Rahu doing? The first thing is we have to check Rahu's dispositor. All right, Rahu's dispositor. Where is Rahu's dispositor? Who is Rahu's dispositor? Which dispositor means who is the planet which rules the sign where Rahu is sitting. So Rahu is in Cancer in the 10th house. Okay, Cancer is ruled by the moon, so therefore Rahu will give results of the moon. Okay, so therefore moon is very prominently linked to Rahu, all right, because he is the dispositor. Then number two is we have to see which planets are he conjunct with, all right. So which are the planets he is conjunct with? He is conjunct with Sun and he is conjunct with Venus, all right. So therefore these two planets are very crucial for him, all right. Then we have to see if any other planet is aspecting Rahu. Is any other planet aspecting Rahu? Moon is not aspecting, but Moon is already linked because he is giving results of Rahu. He's the dispositor. Then Saturn is not aspecting. Jupiter is not aspecting. Mars is not aspecting. Mercury is not aspecting. All right. So therefore, we can conclude that there are no planets aspecting Rahu. So if suppose, let's assume, suppose this Mars was with Ketu, okay, Mars was exalted in Capricorn, then the aspects of Mars, the aspect of Mars will make Rahu give the results of Mars also, which means Rahu Ketu gives results of the planets which aspect them, okay, not which they aspect. So which means if suppose Mars was here, then Mars would aspect Rahu, or suppose if Mars would be in Aries in seventh house, then it would aspect Rahu. So then it would also give the results of Mars, okay. But now for Rahu, there are no planets aspecting Rahu, but for Ketu, Venus is aspecting Ketu, Sun is aspecting Ketu, okay. And these aspects should be taken from the Rashi chart. Aspects should always be taken from the Rashi chart, irrespective of degrees. Forget it. Forget Bhav chart here. And then the last thing is Rahu's placement. So where is Rahu placed? Okay. That should be taken from the Bhava chart. Okay. So here, if you see, Rahu is in the ninth house in the Bhava chart. All right. So Rahu will also give results of the ninth house. All right. So let's keep that aside. So now, if you know for massive wealth in a person's horoscope, there must be a link between certain houses. The second house should be linked, the sixth house, then the 10th house, and the 11th house. All right. And if the ascendant is also there, then this is literally fantastic. This is like beyond imagination. All right. So here, what is happening? You see, this person started in Venus Mahadasha. He was born in Purvashada 3, so Venus Mahadasha. Then he was under Sun Mahadasha. Then he was under Moon Mahadasha, and then Mars. And his life was fine, decent, but as soon as his Rahu Mahadasha started 6 years back, this is all exactly almost 6 years back, okay. So his life totally changed. Because you saw Rahu in the Bhav chart is in the ninth house, he went abroad, he went to the US and he went into consulting, and he made so much money actually. Okay, and if you see these dashas which he has, they are back to back fantastic, Jupiter, Saturn, and these two will consume most of his life. Okay, so we will discuss about dashas later, but here let's start. So Rahu is conjunct which planet? So first rule I said dispositor, all right. So Rahu is giving results of Moon because he Moon is the dispositor. So Moon indicates the third house and 10th house. So third house is the prime house of consulting, all right. And therefore this consulting feature is directly linked with Rahu, all right, because his dispositor is sitting in the third house, all right. But the thing is, there are many consultants. Many people are into consulting and they are struggling to get clients in any field. It can be any area, okay. And just by having Rahu's dispositor in the third won't make you earn a lot of money, all right? That's not possible. For money, you have to check if the money houses are involved. Therefore, the most strongest money houses are the 10th and the 11th. Which is absolutely clear, there's no doubt about it. So somehow the 10th house and the 11th house has to be associated with the third house. Only then you can claim that you might make tons of money in consulting, otherwise may not be. So here you see the first thing is the ascendant lord is in the 10th house, okay, in the Bhava chart also. So that means Venus is very strongly indicating the 10th house. So ascendant lord in the 10th is a very powerful placement. This is one of the best placements actually, apart from being in the fifth and the ninth, okay, or the ninth, I mean. So now here the planet Venus is the ascendant lord here. So now Rahu, as I said, rule number two gives the results of the planets which it is conjunct. So it will also give results of the ascendant, and it also gives results of the eighth house, okay. And how do you see this eighth house thing? This eighth house gave him results suddenly. Suddenly means out of nowhere. And he never expected that he will make it that big in consulting, but somehow he did. That is because of the eighth house. Eighth house means suddenly you get so much money that if it is linked with the 10th house, if 7th house, then it can give you marriage suddenly, all right? So here, this Venus as the Lagna Lord and the 8th Lord placed in the 10th gave him massive wealth. But it happened in a very unusual and a very sudden way, in a very unpredictable way, all right? And then you see you have Sun conjunct Rahu, which is the 11th Lord. So he will give results of Sun also. So Sun indicates the 11th house. So therefore, in Rahu Mahadasha, all the three houses, the Lagna, the 10th and the 11th, which are the prime houses of wealth and finances, along with the ascendant, became activated. And because the dispositor is in the third house, which is Moon, it was something related to consulting. Okay, third house is Guru Upadesh, what you tell others, what you, ninth house is what the Guru tells you, third house is what you tell others, all right? So, because if you see, third house is like you are sitting here, okay? So, therefore, this is the Upadesh which you are giving actually to others. And that's exactly what consulting is. And then, now if you look at Ketu, then Ketu is a very interesting planet here. Rule number one, you check the dispositors. Where is Ketu's dispositor sitting? Ketu's dispositor is sitting in the 12th house because Ketu is depositing Saturn. You may think Saturn is in 12th house. No, yes. But if you see in the Bhava chart, Saturn is in the 11th house actually. All right. So Ketu doesn't give results of the 12th house. He will give results of the 11th house. Do not forget this. All right. Now, and for Rahu, if you would have seen, Moon in the Bhava chart is also in the third house, all right? So therefore, Rahu's dispositor is in the third house. But Ketu's dispositor's placement, we have to check in the Bhava chart, like for Rahu. So for Rahu, it is the same. Moon is in third here in the Lagna and in the Bhava chart. But for Ketu, Saturn is in 12th house in the Lagna chart and in the Bhava chart, it's in 11th. And placements should also always be taken from the Bhava chart. So this is the 11th house. So Ketu signifies the 11th house. Then it signifies the planets Venus and Sun also. Because I said Rahu Ketu gives results of those planets which aspect them. All right. So therefore, Venus in the Bhava chart, if you see, is in the 10th house, right, as the Lagna Lord. And Sun is already the 11th house, and 11th house is already indicated because Ketu's dispositor is in the 11th house in the Bhava chart. Now it's very interesting. Ketu will also give results of the 5th house because Ketu's dispositor Saturn is also ruling the 5th house. All right, do not forget this. Never forget that. And in the Bhava chart also, Saturn is the 4th Lord and the 5th Lord. So in the Bhava chart also, sometimes the lordships change. Do not forget that. Okay. And the lordships and placements are always to be taken from the Bhava chart. Do not forget this, all right? And if you check here, Ketu himself is placed, the last rule is where is Ketu placed? In the Bhava chart, he is placed in the third house. So this again indicates consulting. Do you see how powerful this 3-9 axis is for him? Okay, so this is a very powerful chart for consulting, for taking knowledge and for consulting others. So this is what Rahu will do. Rahu will give results of the 10th house along with the Lagna and the 11th. Okay, and the 8th house, because Venus in the Bhava chart, if you see, also rules. Aries is in 8th house, okay, and Libra is in 1st house. So he will give results of the ascendant and the 8th. So it will happen suddenly out of the blue. And then Ketu will also, along with Rahu, give results of the 4th and the 5th. Okay, so when the 4th and the 5th are linked with the 10th house or the 11th house, then the person can sometimes open a school, and the person can sometimes if Venus is linked with that planet. Okay, so here Venus aspects Ketu, do not forget that. So therefore, this Venus having link with Ketu can also give him tendency to do business related to vehicles. That's very crucial here. Now, Sun and Mars are the Karakas for property. Fourth house is by default property and vehicles both. But how will you know Is it property or vehicle? How will you know that? If it is Saturn or Mars linked with the four, then it can be property. Or if it is Venus, it can be vehicles. But now here, there's the catch, you see. You see here what's going on. Mars is aspecting Ketu here with the eighth aspect. And Mars and Saturn is Ketu's dispositor. Okay. And apart from that, Venus is also aspecting. So here, the karakas of property and vehicle, they are both linking with Ketu. So in Ketu's Antardasha, so this is Rahu Mahadasha, which started and his life totally changed. So during this, you know, Ketu period, so what will he end up doing? Will he end up doing property related work or vehicle related work, right? So that requires a detailed analysis, and for that you have to also check the other divisional charts, like Chaturthamsha has to be seen, okay? And we have to check D16 also, okay? D16, not T60, because that shows vehicles. So that will tell us with either will he go into real estate, or if he is into education, or if he is into vehicles, all right? So that we can do some other time, but this is the approach which I'm telling you, okay? So there you go. Consulting is indicated in Rahu, and a lot of name fame, because the 10th house is the house of authority. 10th house means you do not work, you make others work. That is the difference between 10th and 6th. So therefore, if people ask you, oh, 6th house gives you promotion and 10th house gives you promotion, what is the difference? In 6th house, you may continue working, but your pay scale might increase. But in 10th house, what can happen is your pay scale increases, your position increases, you get promotion, but then you will have some subordinates which you will manage, because Sun is the planet which gets Digbali there, alright? So this is how you have to differentiate the 6th from the 10th actually. And because the 11th house is linked, so this will give unimaginable wealth along with the ascendant. Don't forget that the ascendant lord is also involved in this, alright? So this is how you judge the results of Rahu and Ketu. And if you see in the Navamsha, also Rahu is in the 10th house in Virgo. It's a very extraordinarily powerful placement, alright? And the dispositor Mercury is again in the Lagna, very powerful. Okay, so this is how you can study. And one last thing is regarding the next Mahadashas, Jupiter and Saturn. So Jupiter is also indicating the money houses. Okay, again the same thing he will do consulting, because he is the third lord in the Bhava chart and the sixth lord placed in the 11th house. Okay, so again he will be into consulting. And what about Saturn? Saturn is indicating the fourth house in the Bhava chart, the fifth house and the 11th house. So in Saturn, he might move more into property and all the stuff. Okay, so by the year 2048, he might move into property and all this, okay, out of consulting. Okay, so that's a video for a different day. Okay, so this is how you know what Rahu and Ketu will do. And suppose this Rahu was conjunct Mars, indicating the 2nd and the 7th, then this could also give him marriage, because 2nd and 7th houses of marriage. Okay. And you can take this one level further, as I said, with nakshatras, which means if you see, Ketu is placed in Pushya nakshatra. Okay, so Pushya nakshatra is ruled by Saturn. You all know that. And Saturn is again indicating the 4th house, 5th house and the 11th house in the Bhava chart. So this is again fantastic. All right. So that which Ketu indicates by the rule of dispositorship, Rahu also indicates the 4th house when we see through nakshatras, okay? So this is a fantastic horoscope for consulting, for getting into real estate and for education, teaching and creativity sector also. Creativity, not much. We can talk about that some other time. But this is how you judge the results of Rahu and Ketu, okay? So you can go next level to nakshatras also. So for example, if you check Ketu, Ketu is in Uttarashada. Wow, Uttarashada is ruled by the Sun, which is again indicating the 11th house and the 9th house in the Bhava chart, okay? So 11th house and 9th house, a lot of good blessings are coming in his life through this Rahu and Ketu, okay? So that is how you can know at a deeper level what will happen, what will the person end up doing. Okay. So there you go. That is it from my side. So from today, you must never say, I don't know what Rahu Ketu will do. Okay. So you see these principles and you combine the houses, and then by that you can very easily know what Rahu and Ketu will do. Effortlessly you can know. All right. So I'll stop the screen share now. And as usual, thank you very much for your time. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and share it with somebody who is interested or who thinks that nobody can tell what Rahu Ketu will do. All right. So please subscribe to the channel if you are new to it. And if you want a consultation from me, then you can always go down to the description section of my videos. All right. God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.